Forest Druid is Semperis' free tool for AD Tier 0 Reverse Attack Path Analysis Tool. It's an attack path analysis tool because it enumerates multiple interconnected hops to a target. It's a reverse attack path analysis tool because it starts at the target and works its way out, what we call the inside-out approach. And it focuses on AD Tier 0, the crown jewels of AD, often targeted by ransomware. To get started with Forest Druid, download the zip file and extract to your local PC. Collecting data can be done from a command line executable, which will be covered in a separate tutorial, or directly from the UI. When first launching the UI, data will be collected from AD and displayed on the graph and on the table. In the graph visualization, we can see the blue Tier 0 objects and the AD objects that have strong relationships on the Tier 0 objects. The objects that have the relationships are marked as orange and are by default categorized as risky. In this case, we have a user called Tracy Kelly that is a member of the remote desktop users group. Reviewing the UI elements within the graph UI, we can take certain operations on objects by right-clicking on them. We can classify them directly from the graph as a Tier 0 object, which will cause the attack path to be further unraveled on that object, or we can set them as a filter, which we will show later. Also within the graph, we can collapse the entire view and combine all of the Tier 0 objects into a single object. This makes for easier viewing. We can also show labels for all of the objects in the current view. On the top right, we have buttons for increasing and decreasing the number of hops we want to view at any point in time. This allows us to unravel the attack path on all of the objects. Note that in larger environments, the view may get cumbersome and complicated. So usually we'll want to work with one hop from Tier 0, and we will be unraveling attack paths on an object by object basis. On the left of that, we have our screen selection buttons. We can view the UI as a full screen graph, or as a full screen table, or we can go back to the default side-by-side view. Moving to the next item on the UI, we have our main KPI, which is the number of unclassified privilege escalation relationships. When an object that is not designated as Tier 0 has strong relationships on a Tier 0 object, that is considered an unclassified privilege escalation relationship and is in fact risky. Therefore, the number 94 are the actual number of orange dots that we see on the graph, and also the number of entries that we have in the table. Next, we have our classification buttons for the table view. The table view displays the same data that is displayed on the graph UI. Within the table view, we can sort by the types and the domains and the relationships and the names. We can also select multiple objects and classify them from here as Tier 0 objects. We also have a legend on the top right that shows us which objects belong to which category. In this case, because this is the first time we ran Forest Druid, all of the relationships will be marked as risky. Once we start identifying legitimate Tier 0 objects, then these objects will become Tier 0 objects, i.e. green. The process to use Forest Druid is to analyze the risky relationships, look at the objects that have some type of access into Tier 0. In this case, if we want to focus on the remote desktop users group, we can right-click it from the graph and set it as a target filter. This will cause our table to filter and add the filter up here. Now we see all of those objects that have strong relationships into the remote desktop user group. In this case, we'd want to review these and make sure they're legitimate. When we do find a specific object that's legitimate, we can mark it and then classify it as Tier 0. We can do this either by selecting and clicking on the Tier 0 classification, or right-clicking from the graph. When we classify an object as tier 0, the dot will change its color to green and then will unravel to display any new attack paths that have strong relationships on this object. In this case, we find that there are several objects that were added to the graph following our classification as Tracy Kelly. We can now right-click on the Tracy Kelly user object and set it as the target filter. These are all the objects that have a risky relationship on that user object, and now we must also go through them. In this way, we use Forest Druid to iteratively cover all of the risky relationships within Tier 0. The goal is to have multiple blue and green dots that signify our actual Tier 0 perimeter, those legitimate objects that have strong relationships on our default set of Tier 0 objects. Once we've completed this process, we can export all of the data and use that data to inform our monitoring and risk management tools to accurately describe our Tier 0 environment, as well as create the remediation list for removing the permissions that are still risky. Once we've done that, we can go back to Forest Druid and resync the data to make sure that no new changes have been introduced and that our KPI of unclassified privilege escalation relationships goes to zero or near zero.